Hi, I'm Radzi. Now, we live in a world where anyone can publish the news on social media, and that's been a liberating force, allowing individuals to tell stories from around the world in real time. But it also makes it hard to know what and who to trust. Misinformation can reach a huge number of people and very quickly. In this environment, journalists have to work hard to build and maintain trust. One way to do this is by being transparent about inaccurate information and taking steps to correct it quickly. Let's take a look.
Now let's turn to Mexico City because rescuers are still trying to reach a number of people that they think are alive,
including a 13-year-old girl
who is sheltering under a table.
They've managed to pass her food and water but still can't free her.
In September 2017, a major earthquake hit Mexico. It toppled buildings and killed more than 200 people. Amongst the devastation, a story of hope emerged.
Well, there has been an extremely tense rescue operation unfolding at this primary school. The rescuers, of course, say they will continue through day and night until every last child is accounted for. And
that child came to be known as Frida Sofia. The story first appeared in Mexico's national news. Rescuers reportedly said they were able to speak to a little girl who was trapped inside a collapsed school. The Mexican Navy appeared to confirm the story that a young girl was alive under the rubble. International media also picked it up, with the New York Times, Associated Press, and the BBC all reporting the story. Some organizations reported Frida's survival as fact. Others, including the BBC, were more cautious, saying that it was unclear whether a girl called Frida Sofia went to the school. But Frida had already gone viral. Messages of support flooded social media. But then the Mexican Navy apologized for its previous statement. They said that the story of Frida Sofia was not a reality, that there were no signs of survivors in the rubble, and there was no evidence that a girl called Frida Sofia had ever gone to the school. So what did this mean for organizations that had already published the story? The BBC wrote a piece explaining the story of Frida Sofia and how misinformation about the story spread around the world. In order to earn the public's trust, journalists must report accurately on events and be open and transparent when information is wrong. Now you should have a better understanding of why trust and transparency are so important to journalism. In your activity, think about the different ways that journalists can correct errors and show they're working. If you liked that video, I hope you did. Subscribe here because there's plenty more where that came from.